This video is on the Harrier GR1 in War Thunder. Hope you guys enjoy this short intro. Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to have a look at the Harrier GR1. And on this channel, I generally try and keep things with a positive vibe. And with every new War Thunder patch, something comes along that just breaks the game entirely. Now many of you will remember when the Hunter was added with the SRAAMS, and this guy has been brought in at 9.3. And these SRAAMS, these short range missiles, are just far too good. Now these are short range missiles, of course, they do track very well, but they don't track for very long, and you need to get close to your enemy to make sure you secure the kill. But providing you get close enough, which is pretty easy to do because this thing has unbelievable thrust, is pretty much a free kill with the press of two buttons. Now I've said it before and I will say it again, I am not a good pilot. Especially not in jets. But the fact that I can pull off 2 or 3 kills on average is pretty disgusting. But what this means for War Thunder is that any aircraft at 8.3 all the way to 10.3 just suffers at the hands of how many of these things are brought into game. I'm sure there's many of you grinding through the tech tree without paying to win, so if you're playing your MiG-15, there is a strong chance you'll get into a 9.3 game against maybe 6, 8 or even 10 of these things. And with all honesty, there's not much you can do at that stage, and that's where we're at with this aircraft. And I'm always of the opinion, if something is super fun to play and easy to enjoy, but you hate playing against it, that means that vehicle is pretty overpowered. Now of course, if we're playing this thing in the non-conventional sense, yes, it is very fun. The VTOL feature allows you to do some pretty goofy things. But in the hands of Super Meta Andy, this thing is unbelievably good at ARB. Now what I expect to happen with the Harrier here is that it will stay at 9.3 for at least a week, you'll buy it, you'll have a lot of fun with it, and then it'll get chucked up to 9.7 or 10.0, in which case you'll be facing R60s and AM9Js. This particular version has no countermeasures, it's subsonic, so it will definitely go to the ranks of hardly ever used. Now there is a much more balanced version, but it gets absolutely clubbed by the UK variant. This is the US one we'll cover in another video in the future. But for this video, I'm going to be taking it out into ARB with some post commentary, and we'll also be taking it into some ground RB as well. And hopefully sometime within this week, we'll do our obligatory absolutely goofing around doing dumb things in this thing, which I'm far more looking forward to. Alright, without further ado, let's get into some matches. Now you'll see straight from the get-go, this thing has unbelievable thrust. I've spawned in late. There's some other jets here that are on the airfield that are already accelerating, and we just pass them with ease. And this is something that doesn't seem to slow down. You can go straight up into an almost vertical climb and just keep going. The thrust I'm not sure is realistic per se, There's no real way for me to tell. I've never flown a Harrier before, obviously, but it does maintain its energy super good, and you can climb up against afterburning aircraft with relative ease. This thing is unbelievable at climbing, and you're about to see this hopefully in the next 60 seconds or so. Those of you who have already flown this will have noticed that even F-104s, you'll absolutely dust them off the runway and it'll take a very long time for them to actually catch up to you. Now, if you're flying this thing and you get yourself into a spot of trouble, the best way really to get rid of anyone is to start pulling yourself up into a climb. Make sure you're not being locked on by any missiles. If you do, you can dodge them pretty easily using your thrust vectoring. I've got that set up on my mouse wheel for ease of use. But bar anything that's already flying faster than you or another Harrier, nothing is going to catch you there unless you're in a full up tier. Now, I've spotted this US Harrier and I'm just going to keep an eye on where he's going. I'm also just checking round about my altitude as well, just to make sure there's no other teammates around. What I'm going to do here is I'm just going to pull vertical. This guy doesn't look like he's going to come into head on with me. I'm going to already start my tone, pull up, and I'm just going to spike him from below. And just look at that SRAAM. That is just far too much power for one aircraft, and the fact that you get four of these is just absolutely wild. Now, if I had been that enemy aircraft, I would have pulled in basically towards the Harrier that's about to SRAAM me and make sure that he can't get that lock on me properly, which unfortunately puts you in a situation of going into head on with guns. But absolutely the one thing you do not want to happen is get a Harrier on your backside with one of these missiles. If they get close enough, there is really nothing you can do. I have had one or two aircraft dodge me, but it's been at range and it's possible to do, but it's very, very unlikely. I've spotted this F-100. There's no other enemy aircraft round about my altitude with nearly the same energy as me. I'm starting my tone a little bit premature, but I'm going to just try and cut this guy off. I've got him locked up and he's decided to go straight down. But last second, he changes his mind and makes the ultimate mistake against the SRAAM, and he pulls straight into it instead of just straightening up and hopefully outrunning it. Now, you absolutely can outrun a SRAAM. If someone launches at you from 1.5 kilometers away, just stay straight and you've got a very high chance of surviving as long as your speed is fast enough. If you're just below Mach, it's going to take 1.1 kilometers of distance in order for that missile to close on you and kill you. So if you're going fast enough, do not turn into the missile, whatever you do. So I've got my air brake out here. I've spotted this poor Sabre. There's nothing he can do. He's too slow and he's dead as well. Now, if you've been paying attention to the kill feed, that is literally the second last guy that's in the match. The last guy here has just run away, rightly so. But eventually he gets caught up on and he's killed by another SRAAM. Now, if this guy hadn't run to the edge of the map, this would have been a very quick game in less than 3 minutes, which is absolutely unbelievable. Now, this is some footage from the first game I ever played in this Harrier. I'm chasing this F-100. I've already been in a turn, so I've lost quite a lot of my energy. But right now, I'm full flaps out, making a turn with this guy who's got far more speed than me. But you'll see here that I'm able to turn my plane around, get myself pointing straight down, flaps tucked back in again, and we're able to pretty much catch this guy very easily. Now, had this F-100 just completely straightened out and left me for dust, and he definitely would have, he would have been okay. But once again, he dives down after this other hunter and he makes the same mistake as the F-100 from the last clip. He pulls straight into my SRAAM and he's gone. Now, if there had been any other missile in the game, him straightening up would have been a massive mistake, but he turned into it and it was a SRAAM, so he got bit in the backside because of it. That guy as well got destroyed before my missile connected, so I didn't get the kill for him. This guy does, again, the same mistake. Goes straight in and he gets himself taken out as well. Now, you're about to see some Harrier on Harrier action right now. I've got an enemy Harrier that's carrying a lot more energy than I do. He's steamrolling right towards me. I'm not sure if he's got missiles or not, so I'm being very careful, trying to keep my energy up, but start pulling him towards this teammate that's coming in. He's very quick compared to me, and now I'm going to have to start defensive flying. So he lobs his missile. If that had been a SRAAM, it would have been a lot more danger, but I know it's not. So we're now in a scenario where he's coming in for guns. Luckily, managed to dodge his shots here. I've got enough altitude and enough energy that I can try and slow myself down and make him overshoot. And here comes another Harrier. and he's down to a SRAAM because he was focusing me. So the disparity between the US and the UK Harrier is pretty major. The US one doesn't get as good missiles in my opinion, and it only gets two of them. Whereas it has a little bit better performance than the UK Harrier, it doesn't really matter when you've got four SRAAMs to contend with. It's just completely night and day. Now this is the last guy in this match. These two guys have been in the chat really complaining about the Harrier, and rightly so. Like I said, he's in a T2, he's much faster than me. I'm also running out of fuel, so things aren't going very well. I'm just getting my tone ready because it looks like he's slowing down. Then something very strange happens here. I've obviously got 1 second of fuel left at this point and we're out of fuel. This guy is now pulling away from me because I have literally no acceleration whatsoever, and he just jays out. I have no idea why. I think he's pretty annoyed with the Harriers that are flying around, and yeah, so we end up winning this game too. And now on to some ground pounding with said Harrier as well. So I've gone with the four SRAAMs in case we come up against some aircraft. They're very handy for taking out enemy close air support, even helicopters too, they can track those. And I've also got the SNEB rockets underneath as well. So I've gone for the option of less SNEBs, but obviously having that capability to easily take out enemy CAS is a pretty nice thing to have. In this game, our teams kind of dominated them. They're stuck in their spawn. People are using thermals and this map isn't brilliant. In fact, what map really is brilliant for a ground RB? I'm scanning these hedgerows and stuff to try and get my SNEBs on. And one thing you'll notice as well, this thing has the ballistic computer. So I'm abusing that fact. Spotted somebody over here. Now the rockets on this are very inaccurate. I think it's probably something to do with the speed, and the other thing as well is they're difficult to track because you have the nice bright exhaust initially, and when that's extinguished you just have this tiny little black dot that's really difficult to see when it's contrasted with the ground. Now the enemy don't have any SPAA, and it's a big mistake to bring one out anyway. Our team are camping their spawn and there's really no cover against vehicles that have thermals in this scenario. So there's actually very few enemies left on the battlefield, so I'll just do some quick loops around, and I'm kind of enjoying the new lighting system here. Although the sun is up, there's no real shadows on the ground, which I find really strange because sometimes Gaijin does shadows really well, but for some reason on grass maps, the shadows are really weak. I'd like to see a lot more of that. So I'm flying back over. I know there's a guy around about C. I can see him lit up by our teammates here. So I'm going to try and get some long range rockets on this dude. I spot him here last second, get some rockets off, and unfortunately our teammates pick up the kill on him as well. Luckily you see this guy in his spawn just about to leave, get some rockets on him, and he's taken out by the guys who have been spawn camping for the majority of the game. Now as you can see, energy is not a big issue for the Harrier here. I spotted a guy over on the C-cap, he's now been scouted by a friendly, so I'm on my way to deliver the bad news to this guy. But you can see that even though I'm at zero throttle turning around here, there's not really much energy bleed at all. And we're very, very quickly picking back up our pace again. So pulling off there, my air brake's been out this whole entire time, but it doesn't really matter. I'm going in with my thrusters, and because that I assumed this was the last guy, I came in to do a nice little air show. Now at this point I was debating whether or not to go land on the C-cap and get that, but you'll see in a second an enemy helicopter spawns up and I decide to change my mind. This thing's VTOL system is pretty cool. It's very difficult to aim the rockets though from VTOL. Your plane doesn't like to pitch up or pitch down. I think there's some sort of instructor involved in keeping you balanced, so it fights you quite often. So I've got my air brake out, 100% throttle. Tuck my air brake back in again, and off we go to try and take out this helo. It's a really cool scene. Imagine from the tanker's perspective on the ground, I would have looked very impressive. Just get my guns on target, and that's game, set, and match for us. So there's definitely a lot of fun to be had with this aircraft, so long as you're not on the enemy team. I'll be going back to doing my usual videos tomorrow. And I think sometime this week we'll definitely be taking this thing out into ground RB to see what sort of damage we can do with a full loadout of SNEBs. Once again, thank you guys for watching this video. Please leave a like if you liked it. And if you've got anything to say or your own personal opinion, please make sure you put it in the comments below. A huge thank you to everyone on Patreon. There's been so many people signed up this week. just over the past couple of months. It's absolutely mind-blowing. And a special thanks to all the Tier 3 patrons over there. That's Gross Admiral, Big Bearded Moose, Bill L, Gateway, J Tormy, Justin Dallin, Kane the Salt Lord, Rage, Sailcat, Surfer, Firepiper, Trash Panda, Viking God, Warpig, Zema, Yogbo, Sexy, Fearsome Scotsman, and Thumping Bunny. You guys are awesome, and I appreciate you very much. Anyway, thank you guys very much for watching. Much love, and bye-bye.